All set, I take it?
We finished what we could. Delivered supplies, tracked down escaped animals. Trivial tasks as they may be.
That's enough, don't you think? If there was anything more important still undone, that would be a problem in itself.
The vessel is essentially ready for departure. All that remains is to load the final batch of supplies and see everyone on board. Once we've readied the ether burner, that is.
Ah, had a feeling we might find you all here.
Our consultations with the Loperates, too, have run their course. Pleased I am to say that our researchers' concerns have, for the most part, been allayed. Though some insist on making adjustments to the very end. For their part, Living Way and her peers have graciously offered to stay and keep the people company, lest any lingering queries go unanswered.
All that remains is to wait for the refined adamantite.
Alphano, are you there? It's me, Cryo. Your special delivery has arrived. Round up everyone and come to the harbor at once.
Speak of the devil. Let us go at once.
Forgive the intrusion, Master Fortuna. I bring urgent news. A great commotion has broken out in Scholar's Harbor. Your presence is requested with all speed.
Now, where might this delivery be? Oh.
Important, but we cannot accept these without the proper permits.
By the 12? Surely, these can't all be.
Bleeding hellfire! They're bringing them by sea and by air. All these folks in these crates.
More on the way. I've got your adamantite right here. A bigger haul than any of these sorry bastards brought, and that's no lie.
Yes, because you were charged with seeing the shipments from Gridania and Uldar here, along with your own. Give credit where credit is due.
Sounds like the sorry whingy of a sore loser. An hypocrite to boot.
Ain't no way a scrawny whelp like you took a dozen steps inside a Dalaman shard.
I'll have you know I went all the way to the entrance. Furthermore, 'twas my contacts that enabled us to enlist the cooperation of the Sky Pirates.
Left you outside so you wouldn't get anyone killed, did they? Well then, credit where credit's due, you did a right fine job sitting on your ass.
Take that back.
Mate.
My, what a grand welcome party. Hancock and Saruman.
We come bearing relics both sacred and elegant, as well as a few other gifts that may be of help, to be presented with best wishes from the Eastern Alliance. Our friends in Bosnia, for instance, have sent along a few artifacts for the brave allies of the Resistance.
That's you.
And we brought a number of items from Eureka as well, courtesy of one Ejika Sunjika.
He says a little advance warning would have been appreciated by the Bahi.
I myself have come with a sacred relic of Raisin Temple. 'Twas passing fortunate that Senri's dango craving brought us to Kugane. We arrived precisely as Hancock was making his arrangements. Upon learning of your need, we made haste back to Hell's Lid, with our dango, never fear, and consulted with the other auspices. All consented to the lending of Tenzin's legendary Phoenix Blade for this noble cause. Suzaku and Seiryu were nevertheless worried that it might be lost in transit, however, and insisted upon accompanying me to Onokoro, where I had intended to entrust it to our Confederate allies. I thought instead to give it over to Hancock when we chanced to cross paths yet again. But alas, Seiryu remained ill at ease and ordered me see the blade into your hands personally or die trying.
We did, of course, need quite the impressive vessel to get it all here in time. Fortunately, our majestic associates have been more than helpful. 'Tis an honor to join the Warrior of Light on another adventure, they tell me.
It is all wonderful to hear, but what of the extraordinary cost? I shudder to think of the ransom we must pay for such a bounty.
Fret not for your coin purse, young Alphino. Lord Lolorito looks ever towards the profits of the future, and thus the East Aldenar Trading Company went to some lengths to reduce the financial liability. And since the Scions funded the entire venture, not a gill need be rendered up in compensation. Everything is already yours.
We funded the venture? When?
Don't let the name fool you. This coin keeper knows a thing or two about spending. When it comes to capital investiture, a sprinkling of gil here and there will not do. You need enough savings to make waves when it really counts, which is why frugality is paramount. We also have the benefit of a generous patron. Generous being rather an understatement. She has supported us from the shadows since the very founding of the Scions. Ere we even had coffers to fill.
Mother!
Amelia's.
I remain, of course, an entirely neutral party. I simply thought our family's coffers were needlessly full. We can hardly take them with us on your teeny-tiny toy boat, now can we? And we'd be ashamed to leave all that hard-earned wealth unspent.
Waste not!
However did you manage so much in so short a time? We expected word to reach only a fraction of our land.
Did I not tell you I have my ways?
Erendil, you were involved too.
I received a letter from Cryon after we parted ways in Labyrinthus. She explained what the Scions were trying to accomplish. Why you might soon require the services of the Gleaners, spread across the world as we are. I pray you do not interpret this as a betrayal of Charlotte. I accept that the Forum's aim in pushing us to our limits was to preserve what knowledge we have, and I bear you no ill will for it. Yet, in collecting that knowledge, what I came to appreciate most about our star is that there remains so much we do not know. That is why I chose to help the Scions, to combat the obliteration of those countless, undiscovered wonders. I held no illusions that they would be less demanding taskmasters. Though, rest assured, if I had, I would have been sorely disappointed. To make a long story short, the whole of the guild ship cooperated to ensure your call was heard far and wide.
What's this about a ship that can fly to the moon? And why didn't you mention it sooner? The one time you don't beg my aid, your problem's a bloody ship that can fly to the moon.
See it? You brought the team.
Of course. Garland Ironworks finest. You need only point us towards my new favorite ship. Oh, I nearly forgot. We stopped by Whirlit before coming here and picked up a package from Gaius. He's still of the mind that actions make for better penance than words, contrite or otherwise, so we offer none of the latter. What he sent is an Allegan relic Valens used in his weapons experiments. Has a fair bit of refined adamantite in it too.
As you like us not suspect, we've also brought adamantite for Mordona's Dalamud Shard. I admit to some consternation upon first receiving Kral's message. So few Scions remain at the Rising Stones now, far too few for such an expedition. However, the Gleaners were able to secure us reinforcements. Idilshire's treasure hunters, not least among them. I know. Ah, the gobby flock fought. Slowfix's gratitude for the safe return of his daughter has not waned, and he gathered his kin to our side with an astounding quickness. The clash between their machina and the Allegan defences was a sight to behold. I'll wager even you would have been impressed by the magnitude of the gobby booms.
Fascinating as all this is, I fail to see how it explains your presence here. Does Razzathan not have more pressing concerns?
We do. Yet averting the final days would be the most expedient solution. That, and I am indebted to you. Though they chose to take their leave of Thavnir, those you saved in Galimund remain my people. My gratitude is beyond words. 'Tis appropriate that I aid you in kind. If in the doing we bring salvation to others of this star, so much the better. You will recall that I spoke of my father, Midgard Sumur, and his journey across the great expanse. As he traveled betwixt the stars, his resplendent scales drank of the ether in those nigh empty surrounds and imparted to him the strength to persevere. Thinking they might further your cause, I called out to my kin for consent. Ashdaya's answer was silence, as ever. Tiamat and Chris Velgre, however, responded favorably to the suggestion. My sire, too, stirred from his slumber long enough to speak and say, "Very well." Thus have I brought you his own worm scales. Fit them to your purpose. Seek a worthier fate for us all.
You'd be hard-pressed to find someone else so familiar with the unique properties of dragon scales. So I invited myself.
Fuck me! This is so unbelievable. I've gone right back round to believing it again. Forget a 6% gain. Should say.
With all these goodies, we could get 7, no?
10? No! 14% bleeding.
Think of how far we could go! What we could do with that much power! What we could blow up!
If Kokol is duly convinced, then it must be true. In which case, the Scion's end of the bargain has been fulfilled. Would you not agree?
Yes, Father?
I know not what you seek of Hydaelyn, nor for what purpose you would take command of our ship. Yet this much is certain. To do so will be to dictate the fate of this star and the lives upon it, the lives of each and every creature, in their magnitude and their fragility. Do you understand? And are you prepared?
We have seen and we have felt how much each life shapes this world. And so we are determined to abandon none. We understand what is at stake, and we are prepared to bear this burden.
Then I will bear it with you. I beg you, share your struggles with me, as family. You grasped my fingers with such tiny hands the day you were born. I thought my heart might burst. It was love and happiness beyond expression. Overwhelming. And a conviction so powerful that I trembled with something close to rage. I had heard the final days foretold. I swore to myself then and there that I would not let them steal your futures. A great exodus would succeed, must succeed. No sacrifice or sin was worse than the alternative. If anything gave me pause, it was mine own father. The Archon Louisois openly decried Charlien's policies, a perspective which I regarded with increasing disdain as I grew older, yet even as part of me thought him a fool. Perhaps I also hoped that he, of all people, would devise a brilliant means to save my children. A naive hope, but stubborn enough that I could never bring myself to keep you apart. No, that was his doing, when he perished at Cartano, as we pulled that twisted slab of Dalamud from the sea. I remembered the warmth of your newborn touch. Chastened, I vowed never again to suffer any interference in my mission to protect you. No matter that you yourselves wished otherwise. Detest me, fight me tooth and nail, I would suffer it, and more, and be satisfied so long as I could force you onto the ship. I was wrong. You two have grown so much stronger and so much wiser than I dared dream. You have earned the right to walk your own path. And already begun to do so.
Good. Because there are things we care about, and people.
people we love. And none of them is replaceable. Not a one.
It cannot have been an easy journey for you to have come so far.
We shall be glad to acquaint you with the finer details someday, once this danger has passed. All that we have seen and heard, that we have felt and learned in our travels. Ours is not a kind world, but it is beautiful. Always.
Oh no. Are you quite sure that's wise? After all, someone turns pale and flees the room when he sees so much as an envelope containing word of your adventures. Whatever will happen if he learns what you were really up to?
Amelians.
Though I have wronged my children most gravely, I owe you an apology as well. I assume that it was the Scion's influence that made them so keen to charge headlong into danger. Yours, in particular. I see now that said influence instead brought them together with the many fine people gathered here today. In which case, I hope you continue to guide them.
If we've finished loitering about the harbor, might I suggest we put our plans into motion? People are beginning to look confused.
Perhaps you can spare a few words ere they resume the tedious lugging of cargo. You've no small number of friends and admirers here, after all.
Assistance is appreciated. Now, in an orderly fashion, if you please.